So now here we have the Earth, CNA, where the sun's rays strike vertically, Alexandria, where they strike an angle alpha, and this angle alpha is the same as this angle alpha, and we're hoping we can use that to calculate the circumference. Well, let's see. We know there's 360 degrees in a full circle. This alpha is going to represent some fraction of that 360 degrees, maybe a half, maybe a quarter, we don't know yet. What we do know is that the ratio of this length, I'm going to call this length d, to the full circumference of the Earth must be equal to the ratio of this angle over 360 degrees. Now, I'll talk about that more in a second, but let's just write that down. The ratio of this distance d to the full circumference of the Earth is also equal to the ratio of alpha to 360 degrees. A good way to confirm that this equation makes sense is, let's think of some limiting cases. What if alpha were zero? So that would be a really, really tiny angle, covering absolutely no distance. Zero over 360 equals zero. That would mean this length would have to be zero as well. Good. Now, what if alpha were a full 360 degrees? What would d have to be for this formula to make sense? Check the appropriate box. Would d have to be 0, 1, or c, the circumference of the Earth?